Constable.
Listen, Captain. You hear it?
You mean the bubbles?
Soothing, isn't it? You know, before I became a solid, I never heard that. I had no sense of taste, so I never paid much attention to food or drink. I had no idea how seductive they could be. Would you like me to get you a glass?
I'm on duty.
I'm not.
I thought you were always on duty.
You know, at first I found the whole process of ingestion disgusting. But now that I've gotten used to it, I find eating and drinking to be quite comforting. It's one of the few things that you... that we humanoids have control over.
Quark! What are you doing back there?
What does it look like I'm doing?
We're closed.
Have a seat.
You're in a good mood.
Yes, I am.
Which means you're probably about to arrest me on some trumped-up charge.
Not at all. I am buying you a drink.
Why?
Dr. Mora has gone to sleep, and I still feel like celebrating.
What are you up to?
I am happy, Quark. Can't you just accept that?
No, it doesn't fit. If you're happy, there's something very wrong in the world. The center cannot hold.
There we go.
I've got it. You're getting back at me for selling you that sick changeling.
Actually, I should thank you.
If you want the money back, just say so.
It changed my life. Here's to you, Quark.
All right. I confess. I don't know what I did, but I did it. Just stop. I can't take it anymore.
Do you ever think about having children?
Huh?
See, I never did. It just seemed like too much trouble. But then, fate dropped one into my lap, and I couldn't be happier. Cheers. Strange. Over the past few months, I came to accept the fact that I'd never have any contact with my people again. They rejected me. They turned me into a humanoid. Part of me was lost forever. But that little ball of goo back in the lab changed everything. I feel as if I'm experiencing what it is to be a changeling again. And somehow, being a solid doesn't seem so bad anymore.
Fill me up.